Hi students, welcome to history class. Before starting lesson, I am asking some questions from previous class. Can you remember the contributions of Christianity? Christianity has taught the noble principles of peace and brotherhood to the world. Educational institutions established by churches. Missionaries extended health services all over the world. Christianity introduced Gothic style of architecture. Women and weaker sections of the society highly benefited by education. These are all the contributions of Christianity. Which are the two sects of Christianity, Catholics and Protestants? Who started religious reformation movement in Germany? Martin Luther. Who was Martin Luther? Martin Luther was a German philosopher. Who are called Protestants? The followers of Martin Luther are called Protestants. The students, previous class you studied contributions of Christianity and two sects of Christianity. Let's today's class we learn one more world famous religion, Islam. Okay, first, Islam originated in Arabia. Okay, here, Arabia is a peninsula of West Asia. Peninsula means land covered by water. Then, Arabia is a desert land, so it was not suitable for agriculture. So, Arabs migrated to fertile land. And settled in place. Where water was available. Such places came to be known as Mecca and Medina. Clear this? Islam originated in Arabia. Okay. Here Arabia is a peninsula of West Asia. Okay. So here peninsula means land covered by water. Okay. Then Arabia is a desert land, means dry land. So it was not suitable for the agricultural activities. So Arabs migrated to fertility including land and they settled in place where water was available. In which place water was available? They started to settle in those places. Such places came to be known as Mecca and Medina. In the beginning, Arabs worshipped objects of nature like streams, stones, trees, etc. Okay, Arabs worshipped objects of nature like trees, stones, streams, etc. Here, Kaaba is a very important religious place for Muslims. Okay, then Kaaba is a holy place for Muslims and it present in Mecca. Here Muslims offer their prayer every day turning towards the direction of Kaaba. Okay, Muslims offer prayer every day turning towards the direction of Kaaba. Okay, and there is strong belief in Muslims. What is that? Every Muslim should visit at least once in a Mecca or Kaaba. Okay, here Kaaba is a building in the center of domes. Clear this? Okay, here Arab, in the beginning Arabs worshipped objects of nature including trees, stones, streams, etc. Okay, so Kaaba, it is a very important religious place for Muslims. Okay, how does for Christians church is the very important place? No, in this way for Muslims Kaaba is one of the very important religious place. Okay, and it is one of the holy place for Muslims or sacred place for Muslims. Okay, every day here Muslims offer their prayer to Allah turning towards the direction of Kaaba. Okay, then here Kaaba is a big building in the center of dome. Clear this? Now we may study about life history of Prophet Muhammad. Life history of Prophet Muhammad Paigambar. First, Prophet Muhammad Paigambar was the founder of Islam. Founder of Islam. When and where did he born? He was born in 570 C. at Mecca. Who are his parents? Abdullah and Amina. He lost his parents during his childhood. He brought up under the care of his uncle. Okay, in the beginning, Muhammad was a shepherd. Later, he started to visit Mecca and Syria for business purpose. There he introduced a rich widow, Khadija. She employed him. Later, Muhammad married her. They had two sons and four daughters. Clear this? This is the life history of Prophet Muhammad. Prophet Muhammad Paigambar was the founder of Islam. When and where did he born? He was born in 570 C at Mecca. Who are his parents? Abdullah and Amina were his parents. But he lost his parents during his childhood. Okay. During his childhood days, he lost his parents. So he brought up under the care of his uncle. Okay. his uncle took care of Muhammad Paigambar. Okay, in the beginning, Muhammad Paigambar was a shepherd. Okay, person who rears sheep came to be known as shepherd. In the beginning, Muhammad Paigambar was a shepherd. Later, he started to visit Mecca and Syria for business purpose. For the purpose of business, he started to visit Mecca and Syria. There, he was introduced to a rich widow. Okay, rich widow Khadija. Okay, widow. She lost her husband. Okay, rich widow Khadija. Okay, she gave employment to Muhammad. Okay, she gave job to Muhammad. Okay, later Muhammad married her. So they had two sons and four. When Muhammad Paigambar traveling to different parts, he come across teachings of Christianity and Jews religions. He was attracted by simplicity of Christianity and monotheism of Christianity. Okay, when Muhammad Paigambar traveling to different parts of the world, then he come across teachings of Christianity and Jews religions. Okay, when Muhammad traveling to various parts of the world, he come to know about teachings of Christianity and also Jews religions. Later, he was highly attracted or influenced by simplicity of Christianity, okay, and monotheism of Christianity. Okay, do you know what is monotheism? Monotheism is a belief in a one God. So Muhammad felt it is better than the polytheism of Islam. Okay, he felt monotheism is better than polytheism. Monotheism means a belief in only one God. Polytheism means a belief in a more than one God. Clear this? Here, Muhammad felt monotheism of Christianity is better than polytheism of Christianity. Okay, later he engaged in deep meditation. Okay, Muhammad engaged in a deep meditation on Mount Hira. Okay, why? To find remedies for social and cultural shortcomings of the people. Okay, to find solutions for social and cultural shortcomings of Arabs. Clear this? Okay, later Muhammad started to engage in a deep meditation for long hours on a Mount Hira. Why? To find solutions for the social and cultural problems of Arabs. Okay, so one day he got enlightened from the God. Okay, he got enlightenment. Like enlightenment means he got knowledge from the God. Later he was considered as messengers of God by the people. Okay, people considered him as messengers of God. Okay, so soon preachings of Muhammad Paigambar become very popular among the people and many become his disciples. Okay, teachings of Prophet Muhammad Paigambar very popular among the people, so many become his disciples. How does Jesus Christ has 12 disciples? No, in this way Muhammad Paigambar also have many disciples. Okay, clear this? Here Muhammad started to engage in a deep meditation for long hours on a Mount Hira to find solutions for the social and cultural problems of Arabs. Okay, so one day he got enlightenment or knowledge from the God. Then people considered him as messenger of God. Okay, messenger of God. Okay, so teachings of Prophet Muhammad become popular among the people. Okay, so many become his disciples. Muhammad was in a deep meditation. He used to share his message of God with his disciples. Okay. Here, when Muhammad was in a deep meditation, he used to share messages of God with the disciples. Okay, so these messages considered as messages of God by his disciples. Okay, messages of God by his disciples. And collection of these messages were compiled and published later. Okay, so all these messages of God collected in one holy book, which is that holy book Quran. So Quran became the holy book of Islam. Okay, all messages of God collection of messages in a holy book, which is that holy book Quran. Okay, so Quran became the holy book of Islam. Clear this? When Muhammad was in a deep meditation, he used to share message of God with his disciples. Okay, so these messages here, these were considered as messages of God by his disciples. Okay, so all these messages were collected in a famous holy book, which is that Quran. So Quran book become the holy book of Islam religion. Clear this? Later what happened? Muhammad Paigambar strongly opposed politicism of Mecca people. Okay, Muhammad Paigambar strongly opposed politicism of Mecca people. Okay, here Here, people of Mecca, they worshipped more than one god. Okay, polytheism means worshipping more than one god. Okay, so Muhammad Paigambar strongly opposed to worship of more than one god. Okay, he said there is only one god. Okay, but here some people of Mecca, they don't like this. Okay, so they plan to kill Muhammad Paigambar. Okay, but some people of Mecca, they didn't like this. So they planned to kill Muhammad Paigambar. Okay, but Muhammad Paigambar know the plan of Meccan people. So he traveled from Mecca to Medina. Okay, so plan to Muhammad Paigambar. But Paigambar know this plan. Okay, so he traveled from Mecca to Medina. Mecca to Medina. He traveled from Mecca to Medina in 622 CE. Okay, so this journey came to be known as Hijra. This journey came to be known as Hijra. Clear this? Okay, later what happened? Muhammad Paigambar started to oppose polytheism of Meccans. Okay, here people of Mecca, they worshipped more than one god. But Muhammad Paigambar strongly opposed this. Okay, so he said there is only one god. Okay, he was attracted by the monotheism of Christianity. So he was attracted by this practice. Later he want to follow this practice among the Meccans also. But people of Mecca, they didn't like this. So they planned to kill Muhammad Paigambar. But Muhammad Paigambar know the plan of people of Mecca. So he escaped from that place. Okay, he traveled from Mecca to Medina. Okay, in the year 622 CE. This journey came to be known as Hijra. Muslims considered this incident as a Hijri era. Clear? Hijri era. So what happened when Muhammad traveled from Mecca to Medina? People of Medina welcomed Muhammad with great respect. With great respect. Okay, not only this, they accepted Muhammad as their religious head. They accepted Muhammad as their religious head. Then, after 8 years, war started between people of Mecca and Medina. Okay, so finally people of Medina was successful in defeating the people of Mecca. Okay, people of Medina defeated Meccans. Okay, then Muhammad Paigambar came back to Mecca, and he ordered to remove the images of various gods. He ordered to removal of he ordered for the removal of various gods. Okay, then people of Mecca surrendered. Clear this? Okay, here Muhammad Paigambar traveled from Mecca to Medina. This incident came to be known as Hijra. Okay, so what happened when he traveled from Mecca to Medina? People of Medina welcomed Muhammad with great respect. Not only this, they appointed Muhammad as their religious head. Okay, later what happened? After 8 years, war started between people of Mecca and Medina. Okay, people of Mecca and Medina. Okay, then what happened? People of Medina was successful in defeating the people of Mecca. Okay, so finally what happened? Muhammad Paigambar, okay, he came back to Mecca. Then he ordered for the removal of various gods. Okay, he ordered for the removal of images of various gods. Okay, then people of Mecca completely surrendered to Paigambar. Okay, they accepted his teachings and religion propagated by Prophet Muhammad Paigambar. Okay, so finally Muhammad died in 633 CE. Okay, after the death of Prophet Muhammad Paigambar, teachings of Muhammad Paigambar spread to all over the world. Okay, so Islam became the one of the world famous religion. Okay, nowadays we can get to see popularity of Islam in all over the world. Clear this? Okay, tomorrow class we may study about what are the teachings of Prophet Muhammad Paigambar. Clear this? Now you may write on homework. Who was the founder of Islam? When and where did Muhammad Paigambar born? Who are his parents? Which is the holy book of Islam? What is Hijra? When did Muhammad Paigambar died?
which is the most important religious place for Muslims? Okay, these are all homework questions. You may write all these homework questions in classwork and later send photos through WhatsApp. I will observe it. Okay, thank you students.